Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to look at creating a framed photo in Photoshop Elements. I'm here in Photoshop Elements and I have my image already open and I've sized it down just a little bit so that I can actually see around the surrounds of the image here in the window. That's pretty important right now. Now I'm going to select white as my background color because I want to add some white around the image. So first of all, I'm just going to select around the image just by selecting over it. Now I'm going to add a very, very narrow black border to it. So I'm going to choose Edit and then Stroke Outline Selection. I'm going to add a white pixel black border on the inside just so it's easy to see, and then just click OK. And that will give my image just a 1 pixel black edge, which will stop it from sort of bleeding into the white surrounds. With white as my background color, I'm now going to choose the Crop tool. I'm going to select over my image with the Crop tool. I've selected over and let go of the mouse button. That's pretty critical, the let go bit. And now I'm going to hold the Alt or Option key as I drag out on this corner handle and see what happens when I do. When I drag outwards, I'm adding some extra area around the image. And because I'm using the Alt or Option key, the exact same amount of images being added to the left and right of the image and top and bottom. Now I want this to be a museum style frame, so I'm actually going to let go of the Alt or Option key and then drag down on this bottom so that I get some extra room here. And because white is my background color, when I click the check mark, we're going to have a white border around the image. Now if this were going up on the web onto a website that perhaps had a white background, I might add an extra black edge to it. So again, I'll go and select everything. And I'll go to Edit and then Stroke Outline Selection. I'm going to add a 1 pixel black inside. But you don't have to do that if you're perhaps going to print and you just want this nice museum border effect. Now, the next thing to do is to add our text. So I'm going to click on the Text tool and click here on the image where we're actually going to apply the text. Now, I'm using Myriad Pro, but for this image that's way too big a font size. I'm thinking something like 12 points will be plenty, and I'm just going to type in my name and photography. And it looks like we're using white color, so that's a little bit difficult. Let's go and get a dark gray instead. Now once I've finished typing, I can click the check mark and then I can move it into position just using the Move tool. So I'll place it in position here. And then my image is ready to save or to print whatever I want to do with it. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this very quick video tutorial. Look out for more video tutorials on my YouTube channel. Visit projectwoman.com to find more tips, tricks, and tutorials. And please, if you like this video, click the like button.